Matt, 6 points, 3 for 3 from the field. Will Daniels, 3 for 3 from the field as well with 5 points.
Yeah, and I love how aggressive the new guys are, whether it's Johnson driving the hole or Aminu doing his work from in the hole. I mean, the both of them have just been attacking to start the game tonight, and I like the confidence that shows in two new guys.
But remember, fans, this is a team. Rio Grande Valley averages 107.9 points per game, second in the D-League, and we know they can light it up. Here's Reese Gaines, and he passes, and it is knocked out of bounds. Great defense by Craig Winder. Jam out seven on the shot with which to work. Inbounding will be Patrick Mutombo, who has now checked into the game. For Will Daniels, it is Aminu, Butch, Gaines, Trey Johnson, and Mutombo. Trey Johnson puts up the 12-footer and missed badly. And back the other way comes the Vipers. Outside, pull up three, and knocking it down is number 42.
That's
Ernest
several,
Scott.
That's several times now for the Jam where they just have not gotten back appropriately in transition, and they've had big jump shots hit against them, but they're open jump shots.
And now a bad pass up ahead, and here comes Rio Grande Valley. Kick it outside, three for Scott, and that one's going to bounce in. He's hit 3 of 4 from beyond the arc to give Rio Grande Valley a 13-point advantage.
And just too many shots, too many opportunities, and too many of them wide open for Rio Grande right now. I mean, the Jam have just got to get out better on the shooters, especially when they've proven they can hit those shots.
Scott with 11 points. Here's Trey Johnson, dribble penetration, tried to find a cutting Reese Gaines, and it is stolen by number 42, Ernest Scott.
And that was a good call. Ernest Scott sort of reached out with his feet and grabbed the ball with his feet. Can't do that, fella. So it will be Jam ball with 14 seconds on the shot clock.
And Kenny Hasbrook will return to the Viper lineup, replacing Jonathan Wallace. Jeremy Wise returns, replacing Trey Johnson. Gaines was wide open for the three. Didn't get it on the far side. And now Wise has it between the rings. Ball on the floor, all the way to the rack. Puts up the floater. Nice touch off the window.
That beautiful shot by Jeremy Wise. And now it's just get back on defense for the Jam. And once again, and that time it's Kenny Hasbrook just getting right to the rim with really nobody getting in front of him. And the Jam, a couple of these times, have been back there on defense, but they got a cover.
And getting wide open is number 23, Stanley Asumnu, off the inbounds play. And Aminu picks up his first personal team foul, number 2. And another 2 points.
And that's just defensive miscommunication on the inbounds pass. I mean, there's absolutely no way any player should be able to receive the ball from a baseline inbounds within 5 feet of the basket with no one guarding them. I mean, that's just a letdown. And here you see Will Daniels coming back in for Aude Aminu, and John Edwards is going to get his first action for Brian Butch. But defensively for the Jam right now, it just seems like even when they're back, they're not tight in the face of their man, and that's got to happen here, because like I said, this team can still score, and they got 30 points with almost 4 minutes remaining in this quarter.
And Asumnu makes a three-point play. Stanley Asumnu off the bench has 3 points. John Edwards at 7 foot, 275 into the game out of Kent State. Where's number 33? Bad pass there by Mutombo. And back the other way, and now stolen back by Wise. Here they come, 2-on-1. Gaines gives it up. Wise lay it up and in. Very unselfish play there by Gaines. The Jam got to get back on defense. Taking it all the way is Hasbrook, and he's hit on the head. And we'll get 2 shots.
And that's a tough call against Will Daniels. But again, the problem stems from the fact that Kenny Hasbrook, or no, I'm sorry, that's Stanley Asumnu that time, beat the entire Jam team down the floor. And that's on a made basket. And you really just can't have that happen, especially when you know you're playing a team in the Vipers that likes to run out with the ball. You got to make sure as soon as that ball goes in the net, and maybe for a couple of guys even before that ball goes in the net, get back on defense.
And the first free throw is good by Asumnu. He is a returner, averaging 15 minutes a game. 5.7 points per game of the season. Makes 1 of 2. The ball's batted around, and Asumnu comes away with it. Here's Winder now, up top. With the ball between the rings is Kenny Hasbrook, running the point out of Siena. Screen on Jeremy Wise. Bounce pass down low. Sinsley's picked up by Edwards. Now the double team with Wise here. Kick it out. Down to six on the shot clock. Sinsley back out. Three ball on the way, and it's short by Sumner, but nobody blocked out. Nobody blocked out Winder, and he got an easy put back there.
Yeah, there just hasn't been a commitment to defense and rebounding so far today for the Jam, and that's why they're giving up 34 points so far in this quarter.
And now we've got another offensive foul. Legal screen by John Edwards as he tried to hook the defender. And Will Voigt wants to talk. No, it's going to be Rio Grande Valley taking official timeout. 2:46 to go in the first. 34-19, the Vipers lead the Jam. We'll be back on NBA. For the Jam, shooting 67% from two range and only 1-for-1 from beyond the arc. And turn the ball over six times. Alade Aminu with six, Will Daniels with five, and the Jam got to get some defense going right now.
Yeah, and right now it's just they got to run on defense. I mean, everything this Rio Grande Valley team does is fast, and the Jam have got to just run harder to keep up with it.
And Julian Sinsley is whistled for traveling. Second turnover of the game for the Vipers. Here comes Bakersfield. Now, Julian Sinsley just required mention. It's his first game back, but he knows the system well. Kicking in the corner, trying a three as Reese Gaines. That one is too strong. Rebound far side by 23 is Sumnu. And now nice defensive play there by Gaines. Here comes the Jam. Ball on the floor, hard to the rack. Nice job by Reese Gaines to stick with it and get the lane.
Yeah, nearly lost the handle on that one, but managed to regain control and finish on the right-hand side. And still, though, on defense, the Jam really need a little more intensity, a little more effort.
Reese Gaines with 2 points off the bench here. Sinsley going hard. Missed with the runner. Rebound by Edwards. Out to Wise. Kick out. Reese Gaines faked on the 17-footer. Drove back. Now he loses the handle, and he seems to be having some trouble hanging onto the ball. But he hasn't turned it over. Here's Gaines. Kick out. Patrick Mutombo can't hold on. And a turnover, number seven for Bakersfield.
Yeah, and actually, I think a nice little play by Stanley Asumno. I think he got just enough of that ball to throw off Patrick's timing and force him to jungle it out of bounds. Sometimes all you need is just to put a fingernail on the ball, and that'll change the direction of it enough to screw things up for the offense.
Here's Hasbrook now, guarded by Jeremy Wise. Plenty of time on the shot. 15 now. Here's Sinsley. Ball on the floor, kick out, Hasbrook, three ball, good.
That is a pretty high arcing jump shot that Kenny Hasbrook shoots. And again, just not fast enough on the closeout, and really he got a pretty open look at that.
Well, Hasbrook shooting 31.3% from three land. He is a scorer at 18.3 a game. His other numbers, rebounds, assists, etc., very low. But he is a scorer, and you can't leave him wide open for those threes because Rio Grande Valley will drain them. 37-21, the Vipers with the lead. Reese Gaines fouled. He'll get two shots as Jonathan Wallace comes over to scorer's table and prepares to return to the lineup. Gaines' first free throw is good. And Reese Gaines, unaccustomed to coming off the bench, Matt, and not being in a starting role tonight.
Yeah, and I think, you know, he's a professional, though, and I think Reese will handle that just fine. At the end of the day, he may end up starting again, too, because I certainly think we've learned that the starting lineup is a fluid thing for this Bakersfield Jam team.
Here's Edwards inside. Nice power move by Jonathan Edwards with the jump hook. And Reese Gaines, give him credit for tracking down his own miss.
Yeah, that's turnabout's fair play now after Asumnu rebounded his own free throw miss earlier.
Edwards' his first two. Great theft there by Mutombo. Here's Reese Gaines. Might have been whistled for traveling. No call. Kick out Jeremy Wise. Pump fake on the three into the paint. Off the glass. And we're going to get an offensive foul.
That's a
instead.
Good call. The fans and Coach Voigt aren't going to like that. But Jeremy extended his right arm, put it into the face of the defender. And most of the time, that's going to get you whistled for an offensive foul. So really, not a whole lot to complain about on that play.
Third personal foul assessed to the Jam. First on Jeremy Wise. The Jam is in the bonus because Rio Grande Valley has committed five. Down to 20 seconds in the quarter. Down to 10 on the shot. Ball on the floor is Craig Winder, and we've got a foul on the floor assessed to Reese Gaines. Personal foul number one. Rio Grande Valley will inbound. in front of the Viper bench with 15.8 remaining, and there is a 1.8-second differential between the game and shot. Here's Winder. Now Jonathan Wallace has it. Wallace back in, running the point guard. They're running a four corners all the way to the rack. Count the bucket and one. A great drive. Great drive by Craig Winder, and he's going to get a foul shot as well.
That's just an unbelievable finish by Craig Winder, spinning it high up off the glass. I didn't think he had a prayer of finishing that layup, but that is awfully nice looking for Craig Winder. And a smallish guy, but very, very quick, very athletic.
Craig Winder off the bench with 5 points. Wise will throw it up at the end of the quarter as the buzzer goes off. The Jam trail by 16, and this is not what the Jam faithful expected tonight. We'll step aside. One corner in the books, 40-24 RGV over the Jam on NBA.com/D-League.